Hallelujah. I thank God once again for having this opportunity to share the word of God with you today. I thank you for being together with me, and I know that the Lord will continue to empower us with his word. I continue to urge you to subscribe to my channel to share this word. And for the next 3 days, I want us to be going through a series, reading the word of God together about knowing Christ on a personal level. So follow me closely. When you receive this word, share it with your friends. And I know that the Lord will continue to build us and to make us through this word. Today, I want us to read in the book of John, chapter 1, verse 12. It was the introduction of Jesus Christ. And the Bible says, "But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name." And as we have gone through Easter, and we know that Christ has died and now is risen, as we celebrate that, among all the things that God has given unto us through Christ, it is this adoption to be called the children of God. And that is one beautiful thing. But most of us, when we read this, we don't really understand. And I was among those people that did not really understand. What does it mean to be a child of God? And I remember at a certain in time, God was speaking to me, and he told me that I am not his charity case. And he said in words, he said that you are not charity to me, you are my child. And as I thought about that word, and the Holy Spirit continued to explain it to me, that is where this word came in play, that he has given me power to become a child of God. So if you are born again, you are not at a charity case unto God. What does that mean? I want to break it down that I may bring you to this point that God brought me, and it really changed my life. It changed my prayer life. It changed my service to God, because all the while I was looking at God as a master. And everything that he were to give me, or everything that I would ask from him, it is something that he would give me out of the willingness of his heart, because that's what charity is. Charity is when you give somebody something because you want to give them. It's not an obligation. It's not a responsibility. But because you feel like you want to bless somebody with something, you want to uplift somebody with something, that is charity. And what God meant when he said that when you receive Christ, you receive power to become a child of God. What this means is that now he is obligated to help you. Now it is his responsibility to feed you. It is his responsibility to clothe you. His responsibility to answer you. And that's the area that God or Christ was bringing us while he died and he rose again. Now, I want to liken this to everyday life. We all have, maybe you have a child, or you know somebody, or you must be a child of somebody. So there is a parent and a child. When a parent is doing things for his child, it is a responsibility. It is their obligation. In fact, if you are a parent and you don't take your children to school because it is a responsibility, you can be sued in a court of law, because that child is entitled to your help. That child is entitled to your money, meaning that when you pay their school fees, in the real words, it's not like you are doing them a favor. It is your responsibility. It is an obligation. And this parent know that they should do this. It is a right of a child to be given food by their parents, not by other people, by the parent. And what God is saying while he's saying that I adopted you as my children, when you receive Jesus Christ, you receive the rights of a son. You receive the rights of a heir in the kingdom of God. What this means is that your issues are God's concern. Your issues, God wants to take care of you. God has a responsibility over your thing. So while you call upon God and you are a child of God, then you have faith in him and you have confidence that because he is my father, he will take care of me. Charity, on the other case, is not an obligation. It's something you decide to do. Like if I decide to take a packet of hunger and give it to my neighbor, that is charity. And if I take that one packet to my neighbor, they don't have they don't have like an opportunity, or they don't have a right to ask me for more, or to ask me question, why did you bring only unga? Why didn't you bring kitoweo? Or why didn't you bring stew? They don't have a right. Why? Because that is charity. And most of us are deceived into thinking that when we get a relationship with Christ, we become a charity case to God. And when you think that you are a charity case to God, then you are not able to trust Him. You are not able to believe Him. You are not able to wait upon Him for what He has promised you. Like when we pick up our stuff and go to visit a children's home, we take what we want. Most of the time, we don't even go to the children's home to ask them what they need. Because it is charity, we give them what we want. And most of us treat God like that. Even when we pray, we are thinking to ourselves, God will give us what He wants anyway. God will do what He wants anyway. God will not listen to me anyway. But that's not the case. While you receive Jesus Christ, you receive the adoption and you became a child of God. That is why I think Jesus was telling His disciples in the book of Matthew chapter 6 and 7, He was saying, don't worry about your life because your Father in heaven, you see that? He did not say because you are God. He said that word because your Father in heaven knows that you need these things. And He will provide unto you. And while I learned that, I began to become charged to live for this God, because I know that I am not chancing with this God. I am not risking with this God, because if He is my Father, then He cares for me. Then He wants me to make it. Then He is for me and He is on my side. And I urge you today that you may come to understand that God wills good for you. Why? Because you are His child. Any of you parent out there that you will bad things for your children, even when you may not be able to provide for them, what you want or what you wish is that you will be able to, that they will grow up, that they will get good education, get good jobs, or maybe become bosses somewhere, own a good business. Those are the things that we wish for our children. And Jesus went ahead in Matthew 7 to say that if you and you are bad people, wills good things for your children, what about your Father in heaven? I want you to know that you have a Father and He cares for you and He never fails. And if only you can trust this, your Father, with your life. I'm talking to those people that have given their life to Jesus, because those are the people that have received the power to be called children of God. I want you, as you go to prayer today, as you go to fasting today, or whatever it is that you want, as you enter into the service of God today, I want you to look at it like this. It is my Father. It is the Father that I am serving. I am calling upon my Father. I am not calling upon an alien, someone that I am seeking help. You know, most of the time, even when we pray, we are praying and calling upon God like He is so far from us. Most of us even pray thinking that He is not willing to help us. And all through the prayer, it's like we are begging, or it's like we are in that point where we are begging God to help us. And in our minds, there is that contention. Does He want to help us? I want to tell you today that if you are a child of God, because you have received power to become a son of God, He is both willing to help you. He is on your side, because now you are His responsibility. Now you are His responsibility. He cares for you. And He wants you to represent Him here on earth. One time, someone told me something. He told me that if you want to know if a man is responsible, if you want to know a good man, you don't look at him. You don't look at what he is driving. You don't even look at what he is wearing. You look at his children. When you look at his children and you see what they are wearing and how he treats his children, which schools they are going to, then you know that this is a good man. Why? Because he is able to take care of his children. Otherwise, if you find a man driving a good car, wearing expensive clothes, but when you go to his house and you look at his children, they are wearing tatters, then that's not a responsible man. And as I link that word with the word we have read today, there are so many of us that are not able to represent God. When people look at us, and they look at the God we worship, they don't see the connection, because we are not able to receive these things from God. We are not able to trust God as our Father. And it's almost as if tunaharibia Mungu jina, ama we are causing people to disrespect God, because when they look at us as the children of God, they don't see God as a responsible Father. But with us trusting God, and that is the place that I want you and I to get to, where we trust God as a Father, where we depend on God as a Father, when we call God as a Father, when we get to that point that God is no longer just God, but He is God and our Father, then we are able to trust Him. We are able to receive, because without faith, we can never be able to receive anything from God. Without us believing in God as a Father that cares for His people, a Father that wants to provide for His people, if we get to that point, then God will be able to present us as His children, even unto the world. And when the people look at us, they will know that we are children of God, and they will desire this adoption unto God. There was a certain time, I have three girls. Three daughters, and I thank God for them. And there was a certain time, the third and the second born, they are so close together, even in their ages, that most of the time when they talk, they have this interesting conversation that I try not to get into, because they have interesting points of view about everything. And there was a time we were walking home, I don't remember where we were from, and they began to talk among us themselves. And the little one said, "Do you know there is a boy in my school that say that he will beat me up?" And then I told him that I will tell my dad, and he told me that he will really beat us up. And then the second born was so like, she looked at her and was trying to convince her, asking her, "Does that boy know who our dad is? Our dad is Superman. Our dad will punch this boy. And he will not only punch this boy, he will punch this boy and punch his dad." And this kid was talking. I did not say nothing. I was just laughing and thinking about it. Then it hit me. These, my babies, they have much faith in their dad than I actually have faith in mine. And they were talking about their father like it's this powerful guy that is able to take over the world, that their dad was this huge wrestler that would take on anyone and he would beat everybody up. And I was thinking to myself, I am a child of God. God is my Father. And most of the time when I am going through some hard time, I don't think as God like that. I don't think to myself, my God is powerful. My God is able to punch these mountains out of my way. My God is able to make a way where there is no way. Most of the time, I'm cowering back, thinking about my troubles, crying about my troubles. I have even found myself in a position where somebody has come and told me what they are going through. And then we sit there and we mope about their situation, thinking that, oh, what are we going to do? Oh, this is happening in this. And these kids challenged me. And I thought, my Father is God. He is the creator of heaven and earth. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 24 that the earth and its fullness belongs to God. And I began to have this point of view that when I am confronted by issues where people come to me and tell me, this is what I'm going through, I tell them, do you know who your father is? Do you know who your daddy is? Because his name is God. He is able to do. There is nothing impossible with him. He is a God that maketh a way where there is no way. He is a God that there is nobody can be able to stand against him. There is a verse in the Bible that says that when he does whatever he does, there is nobody to ask him, what have you done? That is our God. And the beautiful thing is, he's not only God, that is your Father. That is my Father. So what is that that is standing on your way? What is that that is causing you to cower? What is that that is causing your heart to melt down in a fear? Remember who your Father is. Remember that when you received Christ, you received adoption, and now you are a child of God. And while you're going to confront those mountains, do not confront them just like anybody, but confront them as a child of God, saying, I know who my Father is. As I looked at these, my kids, I was beginning to think, they don't even know that their father is human. They don't portray him like he has weaknesses. They portray him like he is this invincible being that would take on anyone and bring them down. Their father, like he was this bold thing that no one can be able to stand against. But they are kids. And I am a child of God. You are a child of God. It is time you cash in that check that you are a child of God and come out and stop living in fear anymore and stop living in complaining anymore and stop living in doubt anymore. But every time you're confronted, you say, I know who my Father is. I know who my Father is, and I know that he is able. Even when you come to your end, you say, I know who my Father is, and I know that he is able to do, and there is nothing impossible with you. So God bless you, and let your Father bless you, and live in that consciousness that you have a Father in heaven. The Bible says in the book of Psalms that just like a father would pity his children, so does God pity them that fear him. If you have a relationship with Christ, you are adopted as son. And now you can go through life in confidence that you are not an orphan. You have a Father in heaven. God bless you so much for listening. And let that word build you up today in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. Father, I thank you. I thank you because I have you to count on. And I thank you because you never fail. You never forsake me. Neither will you ever abandon me. And we humble before you in thanksgiving, O God, committing ourselves unto you, O God, that this consciousness that your word is bringing us unto, O God, that by your Holy Spirit, you will continue to expound it in us, O God, that we will live through life knowing that we have a Father. Thank you, Lord, because you never fail. And thank you because you are taking us to heights. We surrender unto you, and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. If you've not given your life to Jesus, make sure that you do, because then you receive this adoption and you become a child of God. God bless you, and see you next time. Amen.